हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू लर्न इटर्निटी, अ प्लेटफॉर्म टू लर्न एनीथिंग एनी टाइम।
इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ टू वर्क विद द बटन ग्रुप। सो व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय बटन ग्रुप? इन सम केसेस यू विल नीड दैट अ ग्रुप ऑफ सीरीज ऑफ बटन शुड बी स्टैक टुगेदर इन अ सिंगल लाइन, देन यू कैन यूज अ बटन ग्रुप। ओके, सो whenever you there is a situation that you want a button to be stacked together in a single line, then we can use a button group. So in order to use the button group, we just have to create a file. So I have just created this file with a simple Bootstrap CSS, with the Bootstrap JavaScript and one jQuery file. And I added this container and call MD12 inside that. So while working with the button group, you have to add a div with the class called as a button group. So I'm just creating a div with the class of btn-group. Okay, once you click create that, you have to create a button. I am just creating this button with the text one, and I'm just providing this class as btn and btn default. Okay, so you will be having a multiple button inside the button group. So I'm just providing 5 buttons and changing the text of this button to depending on this scenario. Okay, so I'm just changing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so let's go ahead and save this file. Once you save this file, just go ahead and refresh. So let me open that button group file. So as you can see, these are the button, but they are stacked together and they are forming in a single line. Okay, so this is how it works with the button group. The another factor that we can apply in a button group is called as a button toolbar. So what do you mean by button toolbar? Button toolbar is stacking the button group together. So button group is means what? We can stack a button together, but in case of button toolbar, we can stack button group together. So button toolbar will having a button group, and button group will be having some buttons. Okay, so in order to create that, I'm just creating a div with the class of btn toolbar. Okay, and inside that I'm going to specify this button group couple of times. Okay, so I'm just pasting that button group. Let me align this bit. Okay, so let me copy this again and save the file. Okay, so as you can see, it is a stack of button groups. So let me save that and run the file. So as you can see, this is a toolbar which is stacked together as a button group. Okay, so let me take a break over here. And save the file. Okay, so this is called as a button toolbar. The another factor that we have in a button group is called as the sizing of the button group. So in order to change the sizing of the button group, you just have to change the button group to button group LG in order to make it large, button group SM in order to make it small, and button group XS in order to make it even smaller, that is a extra smaller. So I'm just copying this 3 times so you can get an overall idea. So I'm applying a button group access in order to make it extra smaller, SM in order to make it smaller, and LG in order to make it large. Okay, so let me save and refresh. So as you can see, we have a 3 sizing in a button group, that is larger, smaller, and extra smaller. So if you haven't specified any sizing, then it will take a default size. Okay, the next thing we have in a button group is called as vertical variation. So if you specify this button group as button group dash vertical and just go ahead and save and refresh, so as you can see, the button group is displayed in a vertical manner. So if you want certain thing that button group will be displayed in a vertical manner, then you can specify the button group vertical as a class. Okay, so just save that and refresh. As you can see, we have 3 button group with a vertical manner. We can also change the what you can say, the text alignment inside the button group while working with the button group. So in order to do that, you have to make sure that every button is inside the button group, and all this button group inside another button group. So if I'm creating this button, I must have to get this inside the button group. Each button should be inside the button group. So let me take them and assign it to everyone. Okay, so let me just close each team. So you have each button inside the button group, and you have a specified a button group as a parent. So you can specify the button group with a btn group justified in order to make it justified. So button group justified. Okay, so the justify will make it justified, the text will be justified. So if I change this text to left, right, and center, and let me remove this button groups. Okay, just save that file and go ahead and refresh. So as you can see, this button group are get justified with the container. Okay, so that's it about the button group we have. If you have any doubts with the button group, of course you can apply a different class with this button group. So you can specify the button group with the button group defined, and we can specify it with the primary class, and hit refresh, you will be having a blue color. So depending on your requirement, you can change the color of it, you can change the styling of it, you can change the size of the button group. Okay, so this is all about the button group.
So that's it for this tutorial. Hope you understand everything. If you have any doubts, feel free to comment below. Please like this video and subscribe to our channel to stay tuned. Till then, see ya.